Welcome back to CVM at Sunrise. They say respect is an attitude of honoring people and caring about their rights, a moral virtue many patriarchs the world over have spent a lifetime trying to attain. But Father Richard Holong, OJ, has accomplished something greater. He has maintained the form of a devout religious figure who has mustered up a courage and a remarkable strength for helping the less fortunate. We are joined by the man himself, Father Richard Holong. Good morning. Welcome to CVM at Sunrise.
Good morning. Good
morning. And thank you for being here. We're going to be talking about the Jam Reggae Opera in a minute, but it's this year is very special for you. You're celebrating three things. Your Order of Jamaica. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And your 70th birthday.
70th.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
wow.
Long years.
Yes. And you're not stopping. It doesn't seem like.
Well, leave that in the hands of the Lord. Yeah. Yes.
And you're also celebrating the fact that you've spent 50 years of
religious life.
No,
50 years in religion. Yes.
Take us back to how you started. I've heard the story before, but tell us again.
I was Buddhist. My parents are Buddhists. And in Jamaica I was born. Both came as Buddhists. And then I came into Christianity because of the wonderful teachers I had, mm-hmm. who told us about Christ and the incredible things that he did. And I wanted to be like Christ. And so I came into the Christian faith and the Catholic Church.
I know your journey hasn't been easy, Father, and you've encountered a lot of things along the way. But I'm really, and always have been interested in finding out, what is it that keeps you in the ministry, even with all the obstacles that you encounter? Why stay with it?
There is that one determining factor, which is Christ. My depth of love for the Lord, and my depth of love also for the people of Jamaica and the poor especially.
Speak to us about missionaries of the poor. It's not just you doing this work. You have several brothers
that
you're very proud of, always speaking about them. Speak to us about that. Missionaries of the poor.
That's a community of religious men that has been founded locally. It's really ethnic in the sense that all was founded in Jamaica. All the spirituality, the community life, the works originated out of Jamaica, and also much of the support, mm-hmm. such as the music. I remember just seeing some kids bound up and tied up, you know, with ropes and so forth, at one of our places, even tied. And I said, this cannot be. Mm-hmm. It just seemed human persons should not be handled like that. And then, of course, when the home eventide burned down, and over 150 women were killed in, mm-hmm. that fire, in actually a condemned building, my conscience said, the Lord would not want that. So I must do whatever the Lord commands me. So I started working among the people, and then I started seeking help to rebuild the building, but a proper building. And then there was a great big explosion. People thought that I was interfering with the work of the government. Mm-hmm. They thought I was working. I was working against the workers that were there, who are very often very lackadaisical. But my conscience kept pushing me. And then the media, which you can show it shows you what the media can do. The media really exposed all that was happening. Mm-hmm. And then the great rejoicing when the new Golden Age home was built.
Did you ever see or envision yourself reaching where you are right now? Because you've expanded and done so many things. You've launched into musicals, getting so much support, as we can see, from all the people who are involved in this. At what point did you realize, you know, this is something different, something magnificent is happening here?
It's something internal inside yourself. You feel a very deep, satisfying love relationship with Christ, where there is such a closeness that it's like a father and son. You have done my will, you have done according to my word. And I felt that very, very strongly. Mm-hmm. And then when we began to open up places overseas like Haiti, brothers kept coming from Haiti, India, Philippines, Uganda, Kenya, even in the United States, we have now opened a home. And the tremendous joy that it brought both the brothers as well as the poor was extraordinary mm-hmm. to me. And that's all I want to do, to spread the good news, yeah, to those who are inflicted and downcast.
Okay, you're a dancer.
Well.
Yeah, because while you were speaking, we were seeing some of the things that you've been doing over the years. Music has been a huge part of your ministry. So this year, you're doing a jam reggae opera. That's the name of it.
Yes.
And one of the things you said is that there is no speaking.
No speaking.
At all, Father?
Not at all, at all, at all.
It's
drama.
It's an opera.
Mm-hmm. Right, right. It has all the elements of theater, drama, acting, mm-hmm. But it's transformed into pure music. All what would have been the spoken parts becomes sung, becomes music and mm-hmm. dance and so forth.
Okay.
You know, it originated out of Italy.
Right.
16th century.
Just a moment. This is what we're seeing now.
This is Yes, I believe.
Is this Yes or the jam reggae?
This is some of the rehearsal time that you're watching now.
For the jam reggae opera?
The jam reggae opera.
You were saying it originated in Italy.
The opera originated out of Italy and became really widespread. You'll see that it got into Holland, Germany, France, Portugal, mm-hmm. countries like that. It became a superb form of the highest art because it's pure music. It's mm-hmm. there's no acting in it. That is done by words only.
How are you so confident that this will be so well received by the Jamaican public? Because opera is so different from reggae.
Right. Well, that's the point. Mm-hmm. You know, God has a way of doing different things with people. Things that you don't expect to happen. Like you would never think of opera and reggae.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But here mm-hmm. it is. It's what came from the depth of myself mm-hmm. as a Jamaican.
Yes. You see, I told you he's a dance. I told you. Look at that. What new move have you learned this time?
I don't even know the name of them. but they tell me it's like gully creeper and all kinds of things.
You know the gully creeper, Father?
Well, I don't know that I know it, but I try.
Father, the last time you were here, you were showing us that one. And we came every year, you know that's what people look forward to in your performance as well. We know that Father Holong is going to come out there and dance. Any plans to stop? Because if I come to the show and there's no dance by Father Holong, you know,
yes,
we're going to stop the production until.
you think we're joking?
I think you are.
No, we're not. You have to dance. So
we will.
Tell us the dates of the Jam Reggae Opera.
It's the second and the fourth. Second to the fourth, pardon me. Mm-hmm. It's the Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
That's the 2nd to the 4th of October.
October, right, of October. However, we do have performances for the youth and for the schools, which will be on the Thursday, the 1st of October, as well as in the morning of the 2nd of October.
Mm-hmm.
Those are usually crowded. Those are almost pre-sold, so that already you have there about 12,000 who will be coming. And then we have the shows like on the Friday night for the public, which is at 7:30, at the Saturday and the Sunday at 2 o'clock and 6:30 at night.
And tickets?
Tickets are available at many outlets. Mm-hmm. But if they call us, we can send them off to the different outlets, 948-6173.
All right. Thank you very much, Father Richard Holong, for being here today. Funds from Jam Reggae Opera, yes, will go towards building a home for 200 mothers.
200,
and their babies.
And their mother, Holy Innocents, which will be right around Hero Circle.
Mm-hmm.
It's a building that we have. We're breaking ground on the 11th of September.
Oh, well, fantastic. Thank you so much again. All right. When we come back, more CVM at Sunrise.